It's both funny and outrageous that people need to be told, yes, Arab Christians exist. Where do you think Jesus came from? New York? Jesus was Jewish, not Muslim. Liars. Jesus was a Palestinian.
The official X account of Israel posted a video trying to claim that Jesus alayhi salam wasn't Muslim. This is a religious debate, and inshallah, I'm here to do the job. They made Jesus alayhi salam saying what is a Palestinian.
What's a Palestinian?
Inshallah, I'm going to respond accordingly, and I'll ask them a similar question about Judaism and Christianity. So without wasting any time, let's watch the clips and come back.
A day before this guy made this video, we talk on Twitter.
Jesus was a Palestinian.
About exactly this topic. Okay, and obviously, I won this debate very easily. Okay, so I thought to myself, okay, now he understood. Yet, he goes on and makes a video about this topic that I thought, okay, now... So, let's see.
Jesus was a Palestinian. What's a Palestinian? I was Jewish and born in Judea.
This is what we call a distortion of history. To claim being Palestinian wasn't known at the time of Jesus alayhi salam is pure ignorance. Or maybe a deliberate lie.
The word Palestinian in the time of Jesus, if it existed like Palestinian, it was referring to the Philistines, which was a tribe from Crete, a Greek tribe from Crete. Okay, so, but Palestinians, referring to Arabs in Palestine, were invented by Yasser Arafat. The KGB, the secret services of Russia, because they understood they had a PR problem, because the Arab world was much larger than Israel, they tried to invent a smaller group of people in order to play the victimhood card. And they took a word that existed from the Hellenistic time, referring to the Philistines, a Greek tribe from Crete. Okay, and they use this word to invent, in quote marks, an ethnicity called Palestinians, when in fact Palestinians are just Arabs in Palestine. Palestine, this place was called Palestine by the Romans, who wanted to punish the Jews because they revolt against the Roman Empire, and they named this place their sworn enemies, who were the Philistines, the Greeks.
Lie, 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 lie.
According to myjewishlearning.com, the land of Israel in the Hellenistic Age. In the summer of 332 BC, Palestine was conquered by Alexander the Great. The land and people of Israel were now part of the Hellenistic world. Alexander passed through Palestine first on his way to Gaza during his campaign to subjugate the Phoenician coast, and then on his way from Egypt to Babylonia. Alexander the so-called Great did conquer Palestine and not Israel in 332 BC. So 300 years before Jesus alayhi salam, the land was called Palestine. And even according to the history of Herodotus, that area was called Palestine, not Israel, and was mentioned as a district of Syria. This is just a simple way to refute their lies and distortion of history.
First of all, if Alexander was not great, who is great? Guys, I'm Greek and I'm insulted by that. My friend, Alexander, at the age of 24, had conquered almost all the known world. If that person is not great, who is great? Moreover, he civilized the world. He spread the Hellenistic civilization to the world. He essentially civilized the world. And to continue, all the other empires, okay, they didn't conquer in essence anything. They just conquer Alexander's empire. So the Romans, the Ottomans, the Byzantines, okay, everybody just took Alexander's empire. They didn't conquer anything in essence. So if Alexander is not great, who is great? Okay, so Alexander is in fact great. Yes, but this place was not referring to Palestinian Arabs, was referring to the Philistines, a Greek tribe.
But people on TikTok say that you were a Muslim.
That doesn't even make sense. Islam didn't exist until about 600 years after my time.
Islam or Muslim are Arabic words. And to expect Jesus alayhi salam to speak in Arabic is just foolish. Let's play the same game. You claim your religion is Judaism. Okay, show me where the word Judaism appears anywhere in your Hebrew Bible. It doesn't exist. So to claim that the religion of the Jewish people is Judaism thousands of years after the prophets of God is unacceptable. Moses alayhi salam, according to your own corrupted Torah, did he ever call his people to follow Judaism?
The mere fact that you said your corrupted Torah shows, first of all, that your views are not biblical. You don't represent the Bible. According to you, the Bible is corrupted. Secondly, you admit that people who follow the Torah are not Muslims, as they follow a corrupted book. So these people that are not Muslims have a religion called Judaism, following the Torah. Okay? Guys, I will try to make this video short because of YouTube views. Completely shallow reasons. Yes. Okay, please go on.
This is my Bible. Where did Moses alayhi salam name his religion Judaism?
Judaism refers to the religion of the Jews that you just admitted are not Muslims, following the Torah that you just said is corrupted, therefore not Islam. And yet, who is more authoritative to present Moses and the other prophets of the Old Testament? A book arguably made in their time and place and by Moses himself, or a book that came more than a millennia later in Arabia that arbitrarily says the Torah is corrupted? In what strange world a book that comes later attests for the authenticity of the book that comes earlier? That is only the opposite world of Islam. To comprehend how insane that is, imagine I invent now a religion and I call it Islam. And people come and tell me, wait, but what you say now contradicts the Quran. How you call it Islam? And then I say, no, the Quran is wrong. The Quran is corrupted, so I am Islam. The Quran is not true. It's corrupted. That is a stupidity. That is literally what you are claiming.
You don't have the original name of your religion anymore, just like you lost the actual name of God Almighty. According to the Jewish Virtual Library, the word Judaism literally means Judaism, that is the religion of the Yehudim.
Exactly what I said. Judaism is just the religion of the Jews. So what is really your claim? Jews doesn't exist, or Jews have no religion? What is your claim? Please tell us.
Meaning that Judaism is not an actual name of a religion, but just a description of a certain religion of the Jewish people. In common speech, the word Jew is used to refer to all of the physical and spiritual descendants of Jacob, Israel, as well as to the patriarchs Abraham and Isaac and their wives. And the word Judaism is used to refer to their beliefs. Technically, this usage is inaccurate, just as it is technically inaccurate to use the word Indian to refer to the original inhabitants of the Americas. However, this technically inaccurate usage is common both within the Jewish community and outside of it, and it is therefore used throughout this site. Subhanallah, this is a clear admission from the horse's mouth. They are admitting that Judaism is an inaccurate name of the religion of the children of Israel. So
the fallacy you are doing, my friend, I don't know how it's called, but you are focusing to the word Judaism, not to the essence. How you call this fallacy? The grammar, fallacy from grammar. Judaism is just the religion of the Jews based on the Torah. Now you want to call it something else. You want to call it banana. So what? Still, Judaism is a word that corresponds to a meaning. The meaning doesn't change. You make a mute point. Okay, so what you say is in fact a non sequitur. Okay, therefore what? Islam is the true religion, or Islam is the religion of Moses? No connection whatsoever. That's a non sequitur.
So they basically say, if you ask Moses alayhi salam when he was alive, what is Judaism? He'll be like, what is that?
But people on TikTok say your religion is Judaism.
That doesn't even make sense.
Alhamdulillah for the blessing of Islam. They don't even know the name of the religion and dare to claim it is not Islam. Jesus, Moses, Abraham and...
You just admitted it's not Islam because the Torah, according to you, is corrupted. Okay, so the Torah is corrupted, therefore the religion is not Islam. Now, who is more authoritative to be telling about Moses? A book that came more than a millennia later in Arabia, or the book that is arguably made by Moses himself?
All the prophets of God, peace and blessings of Allah be upon them, are Muslims. Indeed, the religion in the sight of Allah is Islam. And those who were given the scripture did not differ, except after not...
This text came more than a millennia after Moses. It's got only theological importance to Muslims. It's got zero relevance to the historicity of Moses. The idea that the Quran came to correct the Bible is silly. The Quran presents bits and pieces of biblical stories without context. The Bible is an elegant book with detailed stories in context and continuity. The biblical stories in the Quran are mutated, incomprehensible summary of the biblical stories out of context and without continuing storytelling. In short, the Quran is a word salad of forged biblical stories in a summary. We know that they are forged because it contains known forgeries, okay, and non-canonical stories. Okay, so we know they are forged. So in what universe a word salad out of context, a summary of the authentic verses, or the authentic stories that came one millennia later, are correcting the authentic detailed stories? Are you serious, my friend? What you are claiming is insane.
Remember, Moses said to his people, "O my people, call in remembrance the favor of Allah unto you, when he produced prophets among you, made you kings, and gave you what he had not given to any other among the peoples. O my people, enter the holy land which Allah has assigned unto you, and turn not back ignominiously, for then will you be overthrown to your own ruin. They said, O Moses, in this land are a people of exceeding strength. Never shall we enter it until they leave it. If once they leave, then shall we enter. But among their God-fearing men were two on whom Allah had bestowed His grace. They said, Assault them at the proper gate. When once you are in, victory will be yours. But on Allah, put your trust if you have faith. They said, O Moses, while they remain there, never shall we be able to enter to the end of time. Go you and your Lord and fight you two while we sit here and watch. He said, O my Lord, I have power only over myself and my brother. So separate us from this rebellious people. Allah said, Therefore will the land be out of their reach for 40 years. In distraction will they wander through the land, but sorrow you not over these rebellious people.
This incomprehensible, out of context story in the Quran is a reference of a story in the Bible, the details of which we find in Numbers, Deuteronomy, and Joshua. In this story, God commands Jews to conquer Palestine, the land that was promised to Jews by God. When Jews got scared to attack the people occupying Palestine, God punished them for their disobedience. The Quran, with this reference, confirms Palestine is the land God promised to the Jews.
The details of this incident are found in the Bible in Numbers, Deuteronomy, and Joshua. The essence of the story is that Moses sent 12 heads of Israel to spy out Palestine. They returned after 40 days and said, We came to the land to which you sent us. It flows with milk and honey. Yet the people who dwell in the land are strong, and the cities are fortified and very large. And besides, we saw the descendants of Anak there, and all the people that we saw in it are men of great stature. And there we saw the Nephilim, and we seemed to ourselves like grasshoppers, and so we seemed to them. Then all the congregation cried out, Would that we had died in the land of Egypt, or would that we had died in this wilderness. Why does the Lord bring us into this land, to fall by the sword? Our wives and our little ones will become a prey. Would it not be better for us to go back to Egypt? At this they were censured for cowardice by 2 of the 12 heads who had spied out Palestine, Joshua and Caleb. Caleb suggested that they should go and seize Palestine. Then both of them said, If the Lord delights in us, He will bring us into this land and give it to us, a land which flows with milk and honey. Only do not rebel against the Lord, and do not fear the people of the land, for the Lord is with us. Do not fear them. But the congregation responded to this by crying out that both ought to be stoned. This so provoked the wrath of God that He commanded that their bodies would fall dead in the wilderness, and that of all their numbers numbered from 20 years old and upward, who had murmured against Him, none would come into the promised land except Caleb and Joshua, that only after an entire generation had passed away and a new generation had sprung up would they be enabled to conquer Palestine. Because of this divine decree, it took the people of Israel 38 years to reach Transjordan from Paran. During this period, all those who had left Egypt in their youth had perished. After the conquest of Transjordan, Moses died.
So guys, the Quran with the first story that we couldn't understand anything, it was half incomprehensible words, came to correct the second story, the Bible, which is elegantly put, detailed from the time of the events, with all the references, with continuing storytelling, in context. And the Quran came with 5 words, incomprehensible word salad, to correct the Bible. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.